President Trump has made more than 12,000 calls from his state. Well, here you go. He has made, as of August, 12,019 false or misleading claims. So our caller, I'm going to fact check our caller. Here's a perfect example. Okay. Our caller was going to come on and say, President Trump made 13,000 false or misleading claims. I've got the actual fact. It is 12,019 false or misleading claims. Now, I could either interpret what he's saying as it's a large number somewhere in the neighborhood of 13. It's upwards of 13,000. But if I wanted to interpret what he said with the express goal of making him into a liar, I could say, no, sir, caller, that is false. That is a falsehood. He only made 12,019 false or misleading statements. The substance of what he said was correct, right? So we might have misspoke. Okay, it was 13,000, not 12,000. Now, if he had said, Trump had said 56,000 lies when it was only 12,000, then, okay, he's knowingly or perhaps just completely ignorant to the actual truth, so he's just kind of making stuff up. But when the number is that close, I could interpret what he said to be a lie, and I could glom onto it with the express purpose of adding another lie to the caller's list. Or I could let it go and say, okay, fine. This is what fact-checking has become. And this is also why, if you'll notice, if you post a story on Facebook, and the one that I noticed a couple of weeks ago was one on NASA admitting that climate change is not man-made or something, automatically, Facebook will post underneath, debunk this story, blah, 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 blah. I cannot tell you how many stories. I'll go back and find all of the fake reporting, all of the stories that were just completely untrue about the Russia investigation, not a single one gets a similar fact check. Not a single one, if you post it, will automatically have that, hey, this story was debunked, and oh, by the way, CNN fired the reporters who wrote this story because it was so false and was determined to be almost defamatory in nature. You see how fact checking works. And this is important to know as we really gear up for the presidential primary. What we really have to look out for as we gear up for this presidential election, that this notion, oh, Trump lies all the time. Well, lying, like beauty, is often in the eye of the beholder. 8:43, Dan O'Donnell in for Jay.
On News Talk 1130 WISN. From the Lynchburg-Largo Total Traffic Center, I'm Dick Albert, 43 southbound, still seeing delays back to County Line Road into around North Avenue, around here to downtown, 26 minutes. I-41 southbound, looking much better, left over volume, Silver Spring down to Capitol Drive, and northbound from the Zoo Interchange up to around Watertown Plank Road. 94 eastbound, a slow go, 84th Street, make that the Zoo Interchange. Down to 35th Street, westbound slow from 35th up to Holly Road. Marlin to downtown, 20 minutes, downtown to Marlin, about 15 minutes. 4394 northbound, still crowded from the Mitchell Interchange to the KK, late to downtown 12. From the Tuttle Traffic Center, I'm Dick Albert.
This report is sponsored by your locally owned Citgo station, Fueling Good. When you go with Citgo, you feel good.